All right, folks, God bless you guys, and welcome to This Is It 4321. Guys, this is beyond your brain. Get ready. You remember The Simpsons and all the predictive programming that was in The Simpsons. This is going to go so far over the top tonight. You just have to watch it. I'm just going to deliver it. So please bear with me as this has been revealed to me in the last day and a half, and I'm still overwhelmed. It's overwhelming. All right, here is right out of the Quran, the Imam Mahdi and the rising sun from the west. I'm going to draw your attention to a couple of things. You're going to see these again later. These are going to come up during the Simpsons episode. As crazy as that sounds, just watch and you'll see. Oh, people, interconnect and be pious and kind to each other. Let me show you what the word interconnect means. Interconnect means to annex, to add, affix, combine, and connect. Okay, so there's just very quickly, we connect, or rather are interconnected with everyone. That's just the use of it in a sentence. So I just think it's important to use it once in a sentence. Oh, so here we are in the Quran. Oh, people, interconnect and be pious and kind to each other by him who has, now everybody pay attention, who has split the seed and created man. So I've shown you in the Bible that the beginning of the Bible, Elohim said, let us create man in our own image. In the image of Elohim created he him, male and female created he them. I showed you that is not El, the Almighty God, that's Elohim, the ones that are in trouble. Well, I've shown you also that the serpent race that was forged by Elohim, the host body system, that interconnected with another race of beings, an angelic race, God's angels, which are referred to as the sheep. So you have the serpent race interconnected with the sheep race. That's why the Vatican's a snake. That's why the mouth of the snake is a dead sheep. That's why the hieroglyph of Akhenaten and Nefertiti shows a serpent being inside Akhenaten, having sex with a girl on her knees, forming a hybrid child, and in the head of the kid is a dead sheep and a reptile. Now, I myself have had people draw pictures of me and say, hey, I drew a picture of you, Johnny, which is, first of all, really weird, but they put a dead sheep on my head and a goat and a serpent eating me. Not just once, not just twice. I've had this on repetitive occasions. There's a dead sheep behind my ear. I mean, why would people be drawing pictures of me, handing me pictures? Hey, I drew a picture of you, Johnny. Okay, you're a freak or what? So anyway, so I'm just making the point. Do you understand how weird that is? But the pictures have the same agenda. A serpent eating a dead sheep. A dead sheep on me. A dead sheep. A serpent and a dead sheep. Akhenaten. A serpent being, and then a reptile in the kid's head, and a dead sheep. I'm going to show you, I've shown you the same agenda over and over. The Vatican, a serpent, and in the mouth is a dead sheep. So the serpent race, obviously, the demonic race, the satanic race, bred with an angelic race, and the angelic race are the ones that took the forbidden fruit. They took the bait. Now I'm going to show you how this all ties into Lahaina. I'm going to show you how it ties into the Quran. Do you know what you just saw out of the Quran on the very, in the very verses that talks about the coming of the Mahdi, the one that will lead the Islamic Jihad, the Caliphate, the one that will, you know, unite Islam, shall be preceded by the sun rising from the place of its setting. That's what it says right there in their own holy book. Well, Obama's logo is the sun rising from the place of its setting, the west. That's his logo. Joe Biden's logo is the continuation of the sun rising, and we know Obama is running the White House. It's a no-brainer. Newt Gingrich, I mean, all these ex-political people are just coming out and saying the quiet part out loud now. We all know. So Obama is represented by the rising sun over and over and over. His mom was in a cult in Sabud called the Rising Sabud, the Rising Sun. I mean, what does it take? Now, let me show you how this all interconnects. So watch this. Who has split the seed and created man. Interconnect, mingle together. You know, like the last seed, the last kingdom of the world shall be the miry clay mixed with the iron, but they will not cleave to one another. Who has split the seed and created man. I just want just wrap your brain around what you're looking at right there. So that means Islam, in their holy book, said their God split the seed and created man. They pray with their head to the ground. What direction? Down, right? The head to the ground, the pit. And the angel of the bottomless pit will arise out of the pit. You know what the word Allah means? To rise. Allah. To rise. In the Bible. Let me clear that up. In the Bible, the word Allah means to rise. He shall rise out of the bottomless pit. Allah. Now, y'all ready? I don't know if you're ready. Okay, here we go. Let me just get started. Now, by the way, just for the record, I'm a little bit overwhelmed with all of this because I know what it is. This is the end of the world, and this is past the human brain, and this is not something that a human brain can just say, oh, isn't this cool? This is way beyond a mental burden. This is way past something that you can carry as a burden. Okay, so now I'm going to read you some excerpts very quickly about the sun rising from the place of its setting, which is the sun rising from the west, and that's Obama's logo. Okay, so I'm going to read to you out of the Quran. Now remember, Obama has in interviews, you know, Freudian slip, John McCain asked me about my Muslim faith, and then the interview went, you mean Christian faith? He goes, oh yeah, Christian faith, like try to blow it off. Just go online and type in Obama is a Muslim, Google images, and I'll just leave it at that. Okay, but here we go. Ready? So without hitting all these names, by Allah, the Al-Kaim will be hidden by the will of Allah for a period of time, and it will be ignored until it is said that he has died or perished, or it is unknown that which valley he has followed. The believers will weep bitterly for him. There will be a, now pay attention here, there will be a turning over as a ship among the waves of the sea. What happens with the ship that's turned over by the waves of the sea? It's turned upside down, isn't it? Yes, it is. It's capsized. Until no one will be saved except those who has promised Allah sincerely, whom Allah has assisted with mercy, of him and whose hearts Allah has fixed faith. Okay, so apparently, and I'm just going from what I'm reading out of their Quran, that's what gets you where you want to be. Your fixed faith on Allah. And this passage right here says, the believers will weep bitterly. There will be a turning over as a ship among the waves of the sea. Okay, that's an inversion, turning a ship upside down. Okay. Until no one will be saved except those who has promised Allah sincerely, whom Allah has assisted with a mercy of him and whose hearts Allah has fixed in faith. Okay, now let me show you a couple other things. Right here, this is he looked at an aperture in the house from which the sun shined into the place of his meeting. Do you know what an aperture is? I'm going to show you in the pictures. It's like a camera lens that opens and closes, an aperture. Like if you were to direct the rays of the sun into a building, that you would choose a way to focus it through an aperture, an opening. Anyone ever see GoldenEye? James Bond, here you go. Okay. He looked at an aperture in the house from which the sun shined into the place of his meeting and said, is this the sun that is shining? I said, yes, it is. By Allah or matter, the imate of Al-Mahdi is brighter than the sun. Does anyone know what that word is? Imate. I don't know how to say it. So anyway, this word right here, Imamat. Imamate. I don't know. It's probably pronounced different than I think because it's from the origin of their language, but that word's important. So it would be nice if they gave me a pronunciation, but I don't see it right here. It means the office of imam right here. So the office of an imam, which is, you know, the hidden imam, the Imam Mahdi will be the last one to lead the world caliphate. That's why Joe Biden in the previous videos I showed you is meeting with his Islamic teacher once a week. Do you find that weird? Really? Okay, here we go. So it also means leadership, one that leads. It is the position of the prophets and the inheritance of the successors. Imamat, leadership indeed, is a representation, khilafa of Allah, and the deputy, read that word for yourself, deputy of the messenger. Okay, now ready? Okay. What did it just say? The one has split the seed and created man. What happened in Genesis 1? Let us create man in our own image. In the image of Elohim created him. Male and female created them. Split the seed into two different things. Now just watch. And he is a representation of Khilafa of Allah, which is the leadership, and the deputy of the messenger. Watch now. Okay, in Genesis 2, thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all the host. The word host, it is not what most people think. It means a mass of persons, especially organized for war, an army. By implication, figurative things like maybe angels and demons, or implication, a campaign, literally or figuratively, specifically hardship, worship, appointed time, service, soldiers, warfare. That's so the host that was created in Genesis 1, which was the host body creating an idol, Genesis 1, 26 and 27. Let us create man in our image. I've shown it to you guys hundreds of times. I told you this is what the Lord showed me. The word image is salam, and it means a representative figure, especially an idol. It means an illusion, like a vain show, a phantom image. Okay, so it's not the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit creating man in Genesis 1. But look at what you're about to see. Okay. And on the seventh day, Elohim, that's of the Supreme God, gods, many in one, of the Supreme God, ended his work. I want you to say that out loud. Properly, deputyship, because the host body is a prison. It's a trap. That's why in our holy book, the Bible, it says, let us create man in our image. And the word image shows it to be an idol, which is God's angels. We're angels. There's angels, there's demons. And there's the host body system where the war takes place. Why do you think it was created in Genesis 1? The host body system was created to facilitate that warfare. It says it right there. And who's the deputy? Satan? Yeah. Okay, so here it is. What is the imamate in the Quran? The position of the prophets and the inheritance of the successors. The imamat leadership indeed is a representation of khilafa of Allah. The deputy, right there, deputy of the messenger. Okay, and the inheritance of imam. Okay, now let's get into what we're looking at. Ready? This is their book. No one will be saved except those who have promised Allah sincerely, whom Allah has assisted with a mercy of him and whose hearts Allah has fixed in faith. He looked at an aperture in the house from which the sun shined into the place of his meeting and said, is this the sun that is shining? I said, yes, it is. By Allah, our matter, the imamate of Al-Mahdi. So the leadership of Al-Mahdi is brighter than the sun. The deputy ship. The deputy ship. That's weird. That's in our Bible. It says, and Elohim created man in his own image, which was the no-no. That's not what angels are supposed to do. That's the forbidden fruit. So it made total sense that the other race set the trap and created it. And it's in their holy book. Just get ready. I'm just getting started. Okay, this is all supernatural. Lord God gave this to me in the last 24 hours, and I've just been like, Okay, here we go. Let's go. Let's keep going. So here we go. I encourage you to get this folder and look at every single picture in order and make sure you look at them all. Now, let's just establish some facts. Okay, these are facts. Okay, there's Obama. Is Obama the Messiah? New American Newsweek. God of all things. Kali. See right here? Okay. The second coming. These are all facts. You're looking at all this. They've elevated this guy to a, godlike status, the God of all things. Here's a number they plugged in one of their videos about Lahaina. They used the number 100. They keep saying over 100. We know there's over 100. What a weird number. That's not even close to the number of people dead. Why do they keep saying over 100? Why don't they get a little closer to the accurate number? But they like the number 100, I noticed. You know why? It means a seething cauldron. Huh, that's weird. What happened in Lahaina? Yeah, it was like a seething cauldron, wasn't it? So I told you, I speak their language. I've shown you. Detective Spooner, iRobot, badge number 4084. What's 4084 in the Bible? I apprehend, catch, and arrest. He's a detective. I'm showing you the exact same gift as when I'm doing this right here. Okay, here you go. Now, let me show you a couple more things. Let's just get, okay, so we've already established all these. The first gay president. This is Newsweek. He's got the rainbow around his head as a halo. Okay, this is not arguable. Be still and know that I am God. That's he read Psalm 46 at the memorial for 9/11. Now, I love you in Christ, but if you can't see it, you can't see it. I have a gift that is beyond supernatural. I had a vision company before I got converted, and the Lord made sure I had a vision company called Vampire Sunglasses. Vlad Eyewear, come out of the darkness and into the light with Vlad Eyewear. Do you think that's even remotely possible that that's what I was doing when the Lord called me? No, that was the Lord saying, you work for me, and I'm going to give you a vision that's so acute. Come out of the darkness and the light with Vlad Eyewear. That's so acute, no one can argue with it. And here we go. There's a serpent. So here's this guy. This is the presidential portrait. That's a fang, but it makes a turn at the corner of his eye. It's a sperm. This is a shadow. It becomes the other fang. So here, there's the eye of the serpent. There's the eye of the serpent. The mouth is open. I'll just show you that much. It's that simple. Here are the leaves I drew in. That is a T-Rex. I love you in Christ. If you don't see it, you don't see it. Okay, here's the whole thing. There's two different parts. There's a T-Rex facing one direction. There's a sheep with its tongue sticking out facing the other direction. And when I color the whole thing and I eliminate the sheep, the whole thing is a T-Rex, and he's crapping out the crap that's coming out of the T-Rex is the tongue of a sheep, because that's how bad they hate the angelic race, and we're the angelic race. And that dead sheep with its tongue sticking out is a representation of us, and that's what they think about us, because they devour us, and he's crapping us out. Okay, so there it is. No-brainer. That's what it is. It's not open for debate. Okay, here you go. Now, David Geffen, do we care? Look, do I care that David Geffen has a 453-foot yacht? I mean, they always like to estimate, here, David Geffen's over 400-foot yacht, but now we need to know it's 453 feet. That's a big red flag. What's 453 mean in the Bible? It means, he is my God. That's what 453 in the Bible is, Elihu, Elihu, and it means, he is my God. It's actually Elihu, Elihu, he is my God. David Geffen's 453-foot yacht called the Rising Sun. And it's there because they did an article and they said Obama and his whatever paramour, I'll just use that word, went on a cruise with David Geffen. So they're letting us know that Obama and his paramour went on a cruise on a He Is My God, the Rising Sun. And Obama's on the boat. Okay, just these are facts. Here we go again. Now, here is the cult of Sabud. Again, this should be a 7.7 lines. And there's eight here. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There's actually seven, and there's seven concentric rings, but the star in the middle is what's the point, seven-pointed star. It's the cult of Sabud, the Rising Sun. That's what Obama's mom was in Indonesia, the Rising Sun. There is Obama's logo, the Rising Sun. Love you in Christ, but there's your Mahdi. When the sun rises from the place of the setting, the hidden Imam is showing up. There's Joe Biden's. We know that Joe Biden is really O'Biden running the show. Everybody knows it. Everyone's saying it. Here's a picture of, that's Akhenaten, worshippers of the sun. I'll let you decide who you think this is right here. If you can tell who this guy is right here wearing the shining one right here. Who's this guy right here? There you go. Okay, interesting costume to wear. Now, let's get down to the data now. Okay, let's go to The Simpsons. We're going back to The Simpsons, and here's what I'm going to do now. I'm going to tie together the Al-Mahdi from the Quran with The Simpsons and show you the interconnection with the Bible now, the words of the Bible, and how the entire Simpson episode is actually biblical, the whole thing. It's also the Quran simultaneously. Do you believe that? Just sit here and watch. Okay, so here's Rodan, the gates of hell. This statue right here, the gates of hell. And then here is Chief Wiggum. And during the Simpsons video, he's sitting there going, what's that Rodan statue that was stolen? Let me think. He's like the thinker. But it's really Rodan, because when you know that this is all about the rising sun and the gates of hell opening up, which is what the coming of the Mahdi and the Antichrist and all that is, well, then you know it's not just the thinker. It's the exact same pose on top of the gates of hell, because the gates of hell are opening. Here we go. That's who I am in Christ. My identity was to warn the world that there is a fire coming to destroy the earth. Just like Noah told everybody, hey, there's a flood coming. Just go look at the 4,000 to 5,000 videos I've done on KleckFiles.com. Okay, here we go. Okay, so here's this sculpture right here. The guy sitting in this position right here, right in the middle, gates of hell. I'll just zero in. Okay, so just very quickly, this is the gates of hell right here. See that? Okay, so they're mocking you by saying, what was that statue? Let me think. It's not the thinker, it's the gates of hell is what they're alluding to. And you know that because of what happens. So here's the gates of hell. You know, go look at the whole statue itself. The whole thing is unbelievable. Okay, here we go. Let's keep going back to here. Now, this might be a good time to rewatch The Simpsons, but before we watch The Simpsons thing again, I want to show you something I did not know the first time I showed this to you. Okay, so here we go. Chan Jin. Okay, ready? Chan Jin in Chinese means mixed in two. The last kingdom of the world will be the miry clay mixed with the iron, mixed in two. Do y'all know what smelting is? Smelting is when you melt metal to an extremely high temperature in order to extract other pure forms of metal. It's melting metal and then some. Okay, so you can go look that up. But remember, Chan Jin means mixed in two. That's what Chan Jin means. And then smelting is the melting of metal. Okay, and so I'm going to show you a couple things that go with that. Just remember these. I'm giving them to you before you see it. Now let me show you a couple more things about Maui. Maui is actually the trickster god. Maui is a demigod who's popular in the native Hawaiian culture. He is known for being the trickster. It is said that he owns a great fish hook. Oh, I see. You mean for bringing down God's angels with a fish hook. But that fish hook was used to bring islands up out of the sea with a great fish hook. You know, a fish hook. Told you. Told you guys. A great fish hook called whatever, Mana, Kalani, whatever. And the legend is that Maui was created, that Maui created the Hawaiian Islands by tricking his brothers into going fishing. Now, I want you to look at this image that is the stock image for when you type this in. Maui is a trickster god. Look at the image right here. See the sun? Okay, now we're going to look at that a little closer because that's going to be very telling in our upcoming presentation right now. There you go. So I went and found the exact one that they were using to show you Maui. So here's the sun, and it looks like they've directed the energy of the sun down to a single point, which is in his hand. Now remember, does that say aperture? Yeah, aperture. Next, aperture blend. So remember, in the Quran, it's talked about the aperture coming into the house. And we'll go over that one again, because there's, if you focus the rays of the sun through an aperture, like GoldenEye, like James Bond type thing, you would focus those rays and you could do whatever you wanted to them by burning the crap out of them. Just, I wonder what the odds are so far on what I've shown you. Let me show you another thing that's going on. Idalia, now this is absolutely nuts, because a few days ago, Dave the Wave sent me an email that said, top story. And it said, Idalia, and I'm going to pull up the, you know what, let me pull up the one. This would be a more accurate way of showing you what happened. Right here. This is what Dave the Wave sent me. Top story, Atlantic waking up. Now, you see the landmass right here? That's Cuba. And then you see the Yucatan Peninsula, like here and here. Look at the letter X going through these two landmasses, like it's kind of crossing through that doorway. Idalia likely sending heavy rain towards the Gulf. Idalia likely. Now, it says it's the top story, but I went and looked it up. It was nowhere. I was like, well, wait a minute. They're saying this is the top story, but there's nothing on it. It wasn't even classified as a tropical storm. But they were saying it's likely that we're going to have a tropical storm. And when it shows up, we're going to name it Idalia. That's why that title says Idalia likely. Do y'all know what Idalia means? Behold the sun. Have y'all caught what's going on now? Just right now. Do you know now? Oh my God. This Kleck guy has been right all along. Have you caught it now? Idalia. The name of a potential new storm. Idalia possible. Behold the sun. You know, with Sabud, with David Geffen's boat, The Rising Sun, and Obama's on it with whoever. And then you have the cult of Sabud, that Obama's mom was on The Rising Sun. Then Obama's logo is the rising sun from the place of the setting, which is in the Quran. The coming of the Al-Mahdi, the hidden imam, shall be preceded by the sun rising from the place of its setting. That just happens to be Obama, his logo for 2008. Then Joe Biden, his logo just happens to be the continuation of the sun rising over the three stripes of the West flag, when the number three is the angel of the bottomless pit. And in The Simpsons, it just so happens that, like, what's that statue that's missing? What's that statue? And the statue is Rodan, the gates of hell. Now, have you figured out what's going on? Do y'all know the most important thing you can do now is reach out to Jesus and say, I am sorry, I deserve my punishment now. No one's going to save me. No one was going to save their life during the time of the flood of Noah. And I'm here to tell you again, no one should be thinking about trying to save your skin. You should be thinking about trying to save your soul right now. That's where I come in. Turn to Christ, and here you go. Okay, so here it is. Idalia likely, behold the sun. You can't make this stuff up. You couldn't even think this up. I'm going to show it to you right now. Again, here you go. This is not even possible already. Idalia, right here. Idalia. Idalia is a girl's name of Italian origin. It means behold the sun. But let's see, it is an unusual choice for a summer baby. A pretty F unusual choice for a summer baby, particularly a girl with an ancestor named Ida, an epithet of the goddess Aphrodite. Y'all know what an epithet means? An epithet comes from Greek, and it means to put on or to add. In the oldest sense, epithet is simply a descriptive word or phrase, especially when joined by fixed association to the name of someone or something. It could also be a descriptive title. For example, Aphrodite, which is an epithet of behold the sun of Idalia, the name of the storm that they haven't even said is really a storm yet. Aphrodite is given the epithet of goddess of love, beauty, pleasure, procreation. She was depicted as a beautiful woman, also often accompanied by a winged godling Eros, you know, like Eros and Psyche, a godling, where the angel's kissing the girl and he becomes a dead sheep. The angel becomes a dead sheep. You know, like Johnny and the pictures that people hand him. It's solved. This thing's solved. No one can try and say, oh, no, no, you're wrong. No, sorry, it's solved. Here we go. She was depicted, as a beautiful woman, often accompanied with winged goddess, godling Eros. Love, her attributes include a dove, an apple, a scalloped shell, and a mirror. Okay, just remember that. This is all in the folders, and you should look at all these in order. Let me show you an ad campaign that came out a while before the fire. It's called Maui Burst. Okay, and it's only in a Dollar General. When you turn this upside down right here, it becomes another face, obviously with the eyes here and the nose and the mouth here. You can just flip this over. Totem poles always have upside down faces. But the thing that's fascinating is, why are the colors so perfectly chosen for like a firestorm? Because that's what happened in Maui. So now the colors are red, yellow, orange, and white. Maui burst, you know, like a burst. Let me show you the way they wrote that, because I find that interesting as well. So look at the Mountain Dew thing. You see that? That's kind of like a thicker version of a lightning bolt, isn't it? It certainly is. It's just a thicker version of a lightning bolt. I don't want to get into breaking all this down because it's too much time. Go look at this right here. See, it's like a thicker version of a lightning bolt. And look where the center tip is right here. So you have the right side up, upside down, interlocking triangle thing that I've shown you guys over and over. Now, let's talk about an aperture real quick. Remember how it said in the Quran? Only those that will be accepted by Allah that have faith in him. And it says he looked at an aperture in the house from which the sun shined into the place of his meeting and said, is this the sun that is shining? I said, yes, it is. By Allah, our matter is brighter than the sun. The imamate, I'll just say imamate of Al-Mahdi, or the matter, which is the imamate of Al-Mahdi. What's the matter? I mean, what is the plan of Al-Mahdi? Well, there's a religious war in the end of the world. Christians and Muslims face off, and there's going to be a destruction of all Christians, because that's what our holy book says. And it will be permitted that they overcome the saints. Okay, so that other race is going to take over. And here it says right here, by Allah, our matter is brighter than the sun. What just happened in Maui, the trickster god that uses a hook? Well, a lot of people suggest that it was a dew, like Mountain Dew with Maui burst on it. Getting all this? Okay. Okay, now, here we go. It's like enough. Okay, here we go. Let me just click on this. I want to make sure it... Okay, the Imam Mahdi and the rising sun from the west. It says, O people, interconnect. I showed you that. Interconnect and be pious and kind to each other by him who has split the seed and created man. Where's the creation of man? Genesis 1. What did they do? Let's create man in our image. So in the image of Elohim created him. Male and female created him. It made a two-party system right there. And then the Lord God in Genesis 2 allows any angel that want you. We have free will. But if you choose to come into the system and take a host body, you are subject to eternal death. That's why you have to be born again. Because there's a male energy from heaven. There's a twin female energy from the pit. And we get caught in a twin system, which is what the host body is. I'm going to prove that to you during this, so do not go away. Everything you're going to see here is beyond supernatural. This is the resolution of the Word of God. This is the interconnecting of the Quran with the Bible. This is proof that The Simpsons is just, you know, being produced by an entity that's using Matt Groening. You know, of course, God bless him, he died. Great series. I loved it. I thought The Simpsons was one of the best, most exceptional series of all time, but it was being run by the angel of the bottom spit because he owns everybody until you get converted. So it's all his. That's why Satan told Jesus, hey, bow down and worship me. These are my kingdoms. I can give them to you. So everything is perfect now. It fits. Who has split the seed and created man. At that time will come that none of you will find a place for his dinar and his dirham. And Akahili asked him, when will that be? And he said, when you miss your imam and you remain so for a time until he appears to you like the sun. Okay, so. Now, continuing on. And then we're going to play The Simpsons because you got to see these connections. Okay, now. I'm going to show you this right here. I just showed you the word interconnected in the Quran. Interconnect, O people. So that race of beings, interconnect. Here's what does the word interconnect mean? I want you to, what is another word for interconnected? Interspersed, intertwined, homogenized, interwoven, mixed into, mutually dependent. So mixed, mutually dependent, included, tight-knit, mingled. Okay, what does Chan Jin mean? Mixed into. Look up here. Mixed into. Mixed, mingled. You see it? Chan Jin in the Chan Jin I'm showing you is from the Simpsons episode. How in the world did the Simpsons episode get Chan Jin mixed in two into their little, you know, short everything burning presentation? Now watch, here we go. Let's do it. Now I've shown you the stuff. Now we're gonna watch the video. Okay, and then we're gonna go through all these pictures right here until we get down to the bottom, and y'all gotta see it all. And I mean, you're not going to believe what you're seeing. Okay, here we go. Let's do this first. Let's play the video.
Hey, my name is Russell Brunson. I want to welcome you to Voomly.com. And Voomly can literally turn any video into a video funnel.
What a beautiful day for a family stroll. Tell that to my aching back.
It's not a family stroll. Homer forgot where he parked his car last night, and now we have to find it.
What a beautiful day to be in denial.
Yeah, Bart, who cares? The sun is shining, birds are singing, people...
The sun is shining. You heard what Lisa just said? Yeah, Bart, the sun is shining. That's where she started. The sun is shining because the arrival of the Mahdi is here, you guys. Watch.
Now we have to find it.
What a beautiful day to be in denial.
Yeah, Bard, who cares? The sun is shining, birds are singing, people are staring up at the sky in terror.
Do you see it, Lisa? There's nothing there.
And that's where Lardland used to be.
I'm really sorry. I didn't realize the volume was down. I'm going to back this up and play it one more time. There you go. I'm really sorry about that.
What a beautiful day for a family stroll.
Tell that to my aching back.
It's not a family stroll. Homer forgot where he parked his car last night, and now we have to find it.
What a beautiful day to be in denial.
Yeah, Bard, who cares? The sun is shining, birds are singing, people are staring up at the sky in terror.
Do you see it, Lisa? There's nothing there.
And that's where Lardland used to be.
Oh, looks like we better file a report with the Bureau of Missing Statues.
Yeah, be like that time that Rodin statue got stolen. What was the name of that statue again? Let me think. Thinking.
What was the name of that Rodin statue? Auguste Rodin, the Gates of Hell, right here. That's what he's doing. There's no doubt about it. I'm sorry, I don't know what's going on. I'm having some issues. Again, here we go. There it is. There's the Gates of Hell. Here's Chief Wiggins.
Statues.
Yeah, be like that time that Rodin statue got stolen. What was the name of that statue again? Let me think. Thinking. Still thinking.
Either we can fan out and search, or bunch up and riot.
Oh, balderdash and poppycock. I say we do not riot.
Riot! Don't!
Gonna pause it. Now, the whole point here is there's two opposing forces. Riot, don't, riot. And then if you pay attention to the red card, red represents us, Adam. The word Adam is red. Okay, so when they flip over the card on one side, up front is snake. Like serpent, he turns it upside down, him and his guys. I'll say snake and his guys. And then directly opposed to snake on the opposite side is Reverend Lovejoy, you know, Christian. And he flips it the other way and they wipe it down and make it clean. Get it? Because when you get inverted, that's when you get cleaned. Did you know that's in the Bible? Let me show that to you in the Bible. Okay, so here you go in the Bible. Therefore, thus saith the Lord God, the self-existing eternal Jehovah Elohim of Israel, because I am bringing such evil upon Jerusalem and Judah that whosoever heareth of it, both his ears shall tingle, and I will stretch out over Jerusalem the line of Samaria and the plummet of the house of Ahab, and I will wipe Jerusalem. Ready? I will wipe Jerusalem as a man wipeth a dish, wiping it and turning it upside down and cleaning it and turning it to turn over, to overturn, to return, by wiping it and turning it upside down. Oh, wow, look at that. Panim, as the part that turns the face. So it shows you in 2 Kings that when we get clean, like a dish, you wipe it, you clean it, and you turn it upside down right there in 2 Kings. That's how you know you've been cleaned. You've been converted. You've been inverted. You got wiped and you got inverted the other way. You can see the truth. The virgin's a dead sheep. Yes or no? Okay. Here we go. So here we go. Let's keep going. So let's go back to our Simpsons episode. So the statue, where'd it go? Now you have the gates of hell. Now here we go. You got the two opposing teams. Now watch.
Riot! Don't! Riot!
Okay, there's Snake right up front. They made sure there was one eye right there. See Snake? There's Reverend Lovejoy, and then they wipe it down and clean it, just like 2 Kings 21. There you go. This is all done by a spirit. Snake throws the bottle, lights both the flames.
And thanks to the equal number of non-rioters, the total cost of the damage is $0.
Homer, were you in that riot?
Marge, please. I'm a leader in this community.
In response to the outcry, Lord...
I'm just going to tell you, I saw some videos the other day, and they are saying right now they are keeping it very quiet. There are runs on the bank and people's deposits. They're freaked out. They don't want everyone to do it at once because they know that it'll be a mass, you know, a mass rush to the banks to get your money out. Just go look online.
Lad's parent company, Tianjin Mining and Smelting.
Okay, here you go. Tianjin Mining and Smelting. Tianjin Mining and Smelting. Because, you know, we're becoming like the Chinese communists. That's their goal for the United States. I've heard Gates say it that, oh, the Chinese, they have a great, you know, system. And I've heard other world leaders, Klaus Schwab from the WEF, oh, China is a real leader in handling the population and all that. So here we go. Listen.
My Lard Lad's parent company, Tianjin Mining and Smelting and Donuts, has it.
Tianjin Mining and Smelting. Mining and smelting and donuts. Tianjin means mixed into. Smelting is melting metal and past the point of melting, actually. Melting it so much that you can extract a pure form of whatever it is you're trying to extract. Get it? That's why Tianjin is mixed into, because they're extracting their race from the host body system. Do you get it? This is just as obvious as it gets.
Issued the following statement.
Marge, please. I'm a leader in this community.
In response to the outcry, Lard Lad's parent company, Tianjin Mining and Smelting and Donuts, has issued the following statement. We are rebranding Lard Lad with an updated statue.
Ooh, rebranding.
That just means admitting failure, Dad.
Ooh, admitting failure. People of Springfield, please welcome Mr. I know I'm going to mangle this. Lee Fong.
Actually, it's pronounced Robert Chan.
Duh.
And now, please welcome the model for the original Lard Lad, Mr. Laird Lad.
Okay, welcome the original model for the statue. The original model for the statue, Laird Lad. You know what Laird means? Let me show you. It's in the folder. Laird. Okay, now here you go. Laird Lad. Now they wheel this guy up. I noticed right away they put a red bow tie on him. The end of the Hendecagram, which is the host body system. Now, remember, the Statue of Liberty sets on top of an 11-pointed star called a Hendecagram. A Hendecagram in Jewish Kabbalistic cosmology is called the Kalapot, which means the host body. It means a shell, a peel, or a husk. That's what it is. And the Statue of Liberty is standing on top of the host body representation, the 11-pointed star. And at the top, it's got two triangles. And as you go opposite directions, they get to the bottom. And the two become one. So the original model for Laird Lad is, or Lard Lad, is Laird Lad. And they put the bow tie representing the end of the cycle. So if this goes this way, you see the triangle here and this one here with the X in it, XX. One goes this way, one goes this way, and the two ends meet, and you see the bow tie right there? There you go, makes his bow tie, because I read their language. And his name, the original Lard Lad, Mr. Laird Lad. Okay, now look what the name Laird is. Lord of the Land. Do you think that's possible that they named him Laird, Lord of the Land? What did they do in Lahaina, which means, Lahaina means cruel, merciless sun, you know, like the little kids they found huddled up in bathtubs, all burnt to a crisp, little kids in cars burned to a crisp, you know, like merciless, cruel, merciless sun. That's what Lahaina means, where it happened. Look at all the other references to the rising sun. Okay, so this is not even arguable unless you're delusional. This is as obvious as it gets, or you're delusional or you're one of that particular group. So here it is. Lord of the Land, there it is. And that's because the two have come, they made the loop, they're at the bottom, no different than his bow tie. The two have come together, and they're letting you know the cycle has come to an end. And what happens when the cycle comes to an end? The pit opens up. Revelation 9:11, and the pit opens up. That's what the end of the world is all about. And then all the angels that have been destroyed since the beginning of the world, till the pit opens up, you get to see they were all being used to create a locust army to come out of the pit. And they said they'll make war against the Lord God. It's not going to go well for them, but that's what they're doing. Okay, now, but now before I show you the part of the Simpsons, let me just show you this. Okay, so here is the new donut guy from the Simpsons shooting a beam out of it, and you'll see in a second. Here's the word aperture. In optics, an aperture is a hole or an opening through which light travels, more specifically the aperture and the focal length of an optical system determine the cone angle of the bundle of rays that come to a focus in the image plane. So here is from the Simpsons the donut that forms and that has an aperture, and then it forms a direct beam of light like an energy weapon, and it destroys everything in the Simpsons video. Now right below here is there will be a turning over. This is from the Quran. There will be a turning over as a ship among the waves of a sea until no one will be saved except those who has promised Allah sincerely, whom Allah has assisted with a mercy of him, and whose hearts Allah has fixed faith. He looked at an aperture in the house from which the sun shined into the place of his meeting. Let me ask you, is that an aperture? Is that the sun shining? It's a yes or no. That's what the whole video is about. That they create another lard lad, but this is a new one that's smelted, Chanjin smelting, mixed in too, remember? What about the Quran that says, who split the seed of men and created man, split the seed and created man. Well, so in Genesis 1, you get the, let us create man in our image, male and female. So that's the original, just like the Adidas commercials, the upside down race. And then Genesis 2 is the angelic race, when the Lord God forms Adam from the dust and breathes into him the breath of life, and man becomes a living soul. Genesis 1 was the deputy forming the war, you know, the host for war. Genesis 2 is the Lord God putting in his guy as a form of redemption for anyone that will take it during the course of the history of the world. The way you know you've been wiped and cleaned is you get, just like a dish, you get wiped and cleaned and you get turned upside down. You get converted. What happened the night I got saved? Jonathan, read the tags in the clothes you're carrying. 100% nylon? That didn't make any sense. It says 100% nylon. And then the Lord said, Jonathan, turn it upside down, the word nylon. 100% no lying. Our God is the God of truth. Their God's a God of lies and deceit. Our God's a God of heaven. Their God's a God of death in the pit. Our God's a God of life. Their God's the God of death. So the God of death is coming out of his place, taking over the host body system. It's an entity. Do you get it? Here we go. Okay, so there is an aperture, yes or no? And then does it say yes or no in the Quran, there will be a turning over as a ship among the waves of the sea? Okay, until no one's left that unless they worship Allah. He looked at an aperture, yes or no, in the house, from which the sun shined into the place of his meeting, and said, is this the sun shining? And I said, yes, by Allah, our matter is brighter than the sun. What matter? The imamate of Al-Mahdi, the ruler. His program. Okay, now here we go again. Let's go back to the Simpsons. Here we go. You know what? Let me turn this back so we can get here again. One moment. Just kind of want to keep my place a little bit. So there we go. Okay, here we go. Look at this. I want you to look at this and look at this. Yeah, this is from Wikipedia, the trickster god that captured the sun with the fish hook. And here is the Simpsons. Look at this. You're telling me, anyone in the world, that the Lord God has not revealed this to me. Okay. Here we go. Okay, here we go. Ready? Let's get it. Now, you know what? Just as a quick footnote, I wonder what the odds are that the Lord God, a couple days before he started revealing all this, told me to get up in the morning and watch a movie called Enemy at the Gates with Corey and Zach. And then, within 24 hours, Dave the Wave sent me some playlist of Obama from another channel from 2008 that had a playlist, and he just randomly sent it to me without knowing that I'd watched Enemy at the Gates. And when I clicked on it, the first video in the playlist was called Enemy at the Gates. And then subsequently in a the Simpsons video, they have the gates of hell. You think the enemy's at the gates of hell and is opening up? Yes or no? I know it is. There's no doubt. Look at what's going on in society. I mean, we have a media that is just complicit with the lies of the government. That's crazy, guys. It's communism is what it is. They use the media as their propaganda machine. They propagandize the minds of the people, and they lie and cheat and do all kinds of, you know, evil stuff. Everything that they're doing is evil. Okay, here we go. Let's keep going.
This means admitting failure, Dad.
Ooh, admitting failure. People of Springfield, please welcome Mr. I know I'm going to mangle this. Lee Fong.
Actually.
Did he say mingle or mangle? It sounded like he said mingle. I know I'm going to mingle this.
People of Springfield, please welcome Mr. I know I'm going to mangle this. Lee Fong.
Actually, it's pronounced Robert Chan.
Oh, yeah. So interesting. He said, I know I'm going to mingle this. It sounded like plausible deniability, whether he said mangled or mingled. And then he says one name. That's not right. Then he says another name. Get it? Like mingle. Two together. There you go.
Yeah.
And now, please welcome the model for the original Lard Lad, Mr. Laird Lad.
A lot of crazy names today.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Lard Lad's bold, focus-grouped new look.
Okay, ready? Bold, focused group. You know, like an aperture focusing the sun's rays. I give you our bold, focus group. Get it? What about the WEF? They're like the group, right? Focus the rays of the sun. This is a no-brainer.
That doesn't say donuts. That says management overthink.
The thinker. That statue's called the thinker.
It's called the gates of hell.
What? What are we on now? What?
Hippo, let's give the new statue a chance. When the Eiffel Tower was first built, many said it was a steel monstrosity.
It still is.
Fine, but maybe this...
Okay, they are referring to the host body, the human race, just like Lady Gaga calls her followers the little monsters, because it's been fused together now. The two have been fused in the end of the world. That's what the goal is transhumanism. That's the goal. The Twin Towers became the One World Freedom Tower. They're going for their new host body. Do you get it? That has a lot to do with that thing that got stuck in everyone. Mm-hmm. Now, because there was a lot of this thing in it that was metal. So now, here we go.
This will grow on you. Fine, but maybe this will grow on you.
Okay, now this is, again, cryptic. Maybe this will grow on you. Well, the two races, the serpent race mixed with the sheep race at the end of the system, once they get everything in everybody that they needed, then the two will form as a one thing, and there's no way out of the trap. Now, let me show you a little clip from a movie with Harrison Ford that shows you that, where they come out and say it. Well, that's spoiler alert. That's kind of par for the course. Yeah, it's not even findable right now. Doesn't surprise me. Go to our folders, collect files. You can see it. Here we go. Back to The Simpsons.
Give you Lard Lad's bold, focus-grouped new look.
That doesn't say donuts. That says management overthink.
The thinker. That statue's called the thinker. What? What are we on now? What?
Hippo, Let's give the new statue a chance. When the Eiffel Tower was first built, many said it was a steel monstrosity.
It still is.
Fine, but maybe this will grow on you.
This thing sucks.
It's
Okay, for those of y'all that have watched this channel for a while, do you remember the Akimbo? When they put the statue above the courthouse in New York and they had the girl with the ram's horns, the golden girl with ram's horns, she was in the Akimbo position with her elbows out to the side. I did the whole Akimbo thing, which represents the top of the endecagram. It's always the same stuff, guys. They always use the same symbology. So she was doing the Akimbo power position. And then what happens at the end of the Akimbo power position? The two become one, and they always do the Nut thing, like Robert De Niro, Arnold Schwarzenegger, Nut, the Egyptian goddess of the system. Okay, watch. Watch what they do right here. Akimbo. The two women are in Akimbo power position. Once the statue makes the revolution, then they yay, and then she goes into the Nut position. Watch. Okay, now remember, Lahaina means cruel, merciless sun. The thing that sparked all this the other day was it said top story, Idalia. There was no top story. I went and looked. You couldn't really find it anywhere except some people saying there may be a tropical storm, and they showed like this X going through between Cuba and the Yucatan and X, because that signifies that female thing, the X, going through, and it wasn't even named yet. I don't even know if they've named it to date, but it says Adalia possible. Behold the sun, the coming of the Mahdi, their guy. Here we go, watch. So now she's in the Nut position. So is the other. If you go look at the girl behind her, she's doing Nut as well. The two women are doing Nut.
You fools! You've erected a massive concave reflective surface. It will
You've erected a massive concave. You know what concave is? There's convex. So if you have convex, like you going that way, and then the other way is concave. Get it? Concave. You can't think this up. This is everything I've been showing you. Concave, convex. There we go.
You fools! You've erected a massive concave reflective surface. It will focus the sun's beam in a deadly ray.
Okay, now let me just go back and show you how obvious this is when he starts talking about it. Look at the lines in it. See the lines in it? See all the lines? Hang on one sec. Oh, see all the lines right there? Is that like an aperture of a camera? Or is that a hole opening like an aperture? Oh, I froze it at the moment it initiates. Here's an aperture right here. Here's one that just happens to be an aperture that's got five lines in it. But you see the apertures right here, opening. Same exact thing right there, aperture. What's it doing? Focusing the rays of the sun. What's Lahaina mean? What's Lahaina mean? Cruel, merciless sun. What happened in Lahaina? There was a cruel, merciless murder of a bunch of people. What about in the Quran, he looked at an aperture in the house from which the sun shined into the place of his meeting and said, is this the sun that is shining? I said, yes, it is. By Allah, our matter is brighter than the sun. Okay, and what do you think their matter kind of looks like when you see what the word Maui means? Maui is a trickster god that brought islands up from the sea with a hook, capturing the sun. That's it. There it is. I mean, does that look identical to that? Now, do you think this is remotely possible? Just, okay, look, you think any of this is remotely possible? It's all interconnected. Interconnect, O people. Oh, that's what it says in the Quran. Because the serpent race knows they're interconnected with all of us. Duh. They're the ones running the show. Duh. Look how obvious it is now. They're so busted. So here we go. It's a no-brainer. Okay, now let's go back. Let me show you, by the way, interconnection. That split the seed. So the words out of the Quran about Allah who split the seed and created man. Well, is Cain and Abel a split seed? Cain and Abel? I told you one's the serpent race, one's the sheep race. That's what all the pictures people draw of me are. A dead sheep with a serpent eating me. Same thing. Just like this tattoo right here. So see, the reptile is upside down. Abel is the sheep right here. Cain and Abel, split seed. There it is. And then I just turn it back the other way. This is the way the tattoo was. So the sheep's got inverted in the system, and the sheep can't see anything because he's been inverted in the system. But he's certainly interconnected with the serpent race, isn't he? Or the reptilian? Well, sure, because the reptilian's eating him. What about Broken Promises clothing? So you have Broken Promises in these other clothing brands. And this is Death peeking over the wall with an upside-down cross and a lightning bolt. But when you turn it upside down, that's an insect coming out of a pupa, like a locust coming out, hatching from the pit. See? That's what the human host body's used for. It's a hatching place to create another race of beings. I mean, just knocking it out of the park now, guys. Here's a really good way to perceive this. Okay, the name Idalia, which is the new tropical storm, means behold the sun. Okay, here is a comic of Oh, Biden saying, pay no attention to the man behind the curtain. There's Obama behind the curtain with the symbol for communism from China. No, that's a hammer and sickle. I'm sorry. But there's the Obama logo. There's the Obama logo right there. The sun rising over the place of its setting. There it is. I mean, you can't argue with this. There it is. It's as obvious as it gets. Now, let's go back to the video.
Still is.
Fine, but maybe this will grow on you.
This thing sucks.
It's wood. We love it.
Yay! You fools! You've erected a massive concave reflective surface. It will focus the sun's beam in a deadly ray.
Aperture. Aperture. It will focus the sun's beam in a deadly ray. Okay, Marty's mirrors. Pretty important right there. Marty means God of War. Okay, now remember in this, we had... remember Barack's logo is the sun rising over the stripes of the American flag. There's 1, 2, 3, angel of the bottomless pit, the sun rising, Obama's logo. And now the new tropical storm, Idalia, means behold the sun, which is an epithet of the goddess Aphrodite. And Aphrodite is a scallop shell and a mirror. See, so Idalia, which is the new tropical storm that means behold the sun, which everything else has been. Do you see what's going on here? You couldn't even think this up. Now behold the sun, and it's an epithet of Aphrodite, which happens to be a mirror and a clamshell as well. And then here in The Simpsons, Marty's mirrors. Okay. Ed's extinguishers just closed yesterday. What happened in Lahaina? What happened in Cruel Merciless Sun? Didn't some Obama appointee turn off the water? Have y'all seen that? Yes, he did. Some Obama appointee from one of their commissions that had authority not to turn the water on, a guy put there by Obama, wouldn't let him turn the water on to put out their house, put out the fire. Go look it up. Yeah! I want to show y'all this one. This is something I just caught as well. Look what it says. Peephole. H-O-L-E. Peephole. Look at his eyes. These guys' eyes are open. His are closed. He's looking at Peephole magazine. Not people. P-E-O-P-L-E. Peephole. So here we go again. More stuff.
First off, I'd like to thank the good people at Tianjin Smelting and Mining and...
Okay, now, did you hear what he just said again? I would like to thank the good people of Tianjin Smelting and Mining and Donuts. They got a blue cloth over the statue that burned it all down. Blue doesn't burn with certain lasers. I showed you... You know what? Let's see if we can play it. Sometimes it won't play when I'm doing a video. Let's see if we can play it. Let's see.
Laser weapon can be programmed for different wavelengths.
Okay, that's good enough, right? Okay, so back here. So there you go. It's covered in blue.
Donuts and tops for neutralizing our wonderful, deadly new lard lad.
Yeah, that's great.
They'll grow back. The time for mourning and blaming our mayors has passed. We will rebuild.
Okay, so now the time for mourning and blaming our mayors has passed. We will rebuild. That's Obama's Build Back Better. He wrote it on the 11,000 pound of the One World Freedom Tower. We remember, we rebuild, we come back stronger. Who's we? The ones that created the flesh. That's why the Lord God destroyed the flesh. So here's Lahaina. You see the blue umbrellas right here? Here? And then here's the thing from The Simpsons. Blue looks identical to the blue umbrella. See it right there? So this could only be done by a supernatural being that's orchestrating this through the host body system. You're looking at the other side of the equation. So there's the blue umbrella. Here's Lahaina. Same as umbrella right there. Very easy to see. Let's keep going. Now this is something coming up that I did not catch at first. There's two more things that are mind destroying. Watch. Ready?
We will rebuild.
We will rebuild. We will rebuild. We will rebuild.
I'm going to just show you this real quick. Right here, I want you to look at all the other windows except these two right here, identical. Look. There's two boards going down. There's this lighter one, darker one going across. So the same thing right here. They're identical. I mean, literally identical. See them? It's like 2X hidden in plain sight. 259, and then you'll see 233. But when I decrypt their language, sometimes you have to be a little more... savvy on, you can't just pick some number. and think, oh, it's going to be this. You have to pay attention. Watch what happens. The three changes here. Watch this, three changes. Changed it to a four very subtly. So it's 259, 23, and then three. And then it changes to four. So 259, 23, and three, and then four. So let me show you the meanings there. So here's Strong's 259 in the Bible, 259, a taking, capture, capturing, to be taken and conquered. So is that what they're doing? Is that what the serpent race is doing to the sheep race? Of course, I'm watching it actively in my life. I've been watching it since I got saved. I can show this to you over and over and over and over and over again. The Vatican's a snake killing sheep, which are angels. Akhenaten and Nefertiti, it's a serpent being inside a human shell, impregnating a girl on her knees, creating a hybrid serpent and sheep race in the head of the kids. It's a no-brainer now. There's people drawing pictures of me with the exact same agenda. So it's proven. This is court admissible proven. So 259 and then Strong's 23. So Strong's 23 right there, to grieve, to be indignant, to grieve much, hence to be indignant. So right there is 23. Oh, here we go. Sorry, it looks like hopefully we don't experience the crazy attacks, but it wouldn't surprise me. All right, so here we go. 259 to capture and to capture and to be taken and conquered. So that's right there. 259, 23, indignant and to grieve much. Number three, angel of the bottomless pit. And then four means fruit. And when you see the fruit, they put the 2X in front of you here and here. And they'll show it again, but now comes the absolute bust. In the end, the Bible says, in the end, a woman will compass a man. In the end. Why do you think there's all this gender confusion going on in the world? So, watch how they disguise it right here in The Simpsons with this whole clip. Which is the beginning of the gates of hell opening up, which is the beginning of the complete arrival of the Al-Mahdi. The Imam Mahdi is arriving. They're showing you he's arriving through The Simpsons. They're showing you he's arriving through a storm called Idalia, which they said was a top story, which wasn't even a story at all. But they show it going through the two landmasses, the X coming in at you. And then they're probably, I'm sure by now they've upgraded it to a tropical storm. We'll see where it goes, but it means behold the sun. Everything else is about the sun. Even Maui, he used a fish hook and so he used his great fish hook and he is known for stealing fire from humans from the underworld, fishing up islands with his magical fish hook. And capturing the sun to lengthen the days. There it is. Okay, that's in the folder. So I'd pay attention to all of it. I'd go through the whole folder myself. And here we go. Ready? Now you will know at the very end of this clip that it's all about the female energy taking over the male. You'll know right now. Ready? You believe me? You're gonna. Turn it all the way up. Here we go. Ready? I'll make sure it plays long enough. It's the very last thing that said. Here we go. Listen.
We will rebuild. We will rebuild.
I guess there's only one man we can turn to.
I guess there's only one man we can turn to. Supergirl. Told you. Here we go. There it is. There's only one man we can turn to. You know what Supergirl is? Double down. Double downers, that twin female energy, which is the evil, cruel other side of the equation. Pure evil. There it is. There's only one man we can turn to. Listen to him say it.
We will rebuild. We will rebuild.
I guess there's only one man we can turn to.
Supergirl?
There it is. There's only one man we can turn to. Supergirl. Can you believe in the Quran it says split the seed and created man? Now you know. They know. Anyway, it's beyond the human brain. All of this is way past. There's a lot more, so I don't know if I should just keep going. This is some you need to see. The name Yahweh God is right here. The name Yahweh, the original name writing in Hebrew. When you turn it upside down and you press them together, upside down Yahweh spells Allah. So Yahweh, you press them together and turn it upside down and it spells Allah. Yahweh, Allah. My name means Yahweh is given. That's what Jonathan means. When I freaked out because I had my supernatural abilities, I was pretty freaked out and I called out to God, like, what the heck is going on? Why are you showing me this stuff? Who am I to you that you would show me these things? And the Lord told me, open that book over there. There was a book on my table, an art book. And I opened it up and it said, the ancient Israelites believed that names had mystical powers and meanings in many ways reflected the character and destiny of a person. Children were named at birth, except for boys, 8 days later at the time of circumcision. Parents would name their children showing trust and devotion in God and using one of God's appellations. For instance, Jonathan means Yahweh has given. There you go. I just recited it right off the page. Out of my mind. Out of my brain. And so here it is, male and female. So, see, their whole thing is, the female energy is what's running that team. So, and this is all, everything's cryptic. You're looking at it. 259, 23, and 3. Just go look them up. There you go. And then it turns to 4, which means fruit. And then there's Obama winking his eye when he said, my mom, you know, my dad's from Kenya, my mother's from Kansas, and I'm from, and he goes, Hawaii, and he winks his eye. Well, when he winks his eye, that's the exact same thing that the guy does in the movie Time Machine with Guy Pearce. But I want you to look at this guy, I think Orlando, I can't remember, yeah. Anyway, I want you to look at his tie. Do you see something wrong with his tie right here? Why is his tie like a vagina, dude? I mean, do y'all think I'm obsessed with vaginas or something? Used to be. No. Look at that right there. I mean, this is... Now, look at this. Let me play you the clip from this. Let me just play you the clip. Because Obama's winking his eye, same as this guy. And right here in the time machine, listen to what they say.
Ah, I have it. Jules Verne.
Right up your alley, I would think.
Photonic, right?
Well, what's left of one? What's left of all of them? I am the last.
And these fragments I have shored against my ruins. T.S. Eliot. You wouldn't know him yet, but he is so depressing yet so divine.
Oh, I'm sorry. The lending library is temporarily out of service. Not to worry, I have them all right here. Every page of every volume.
Can you tell me what's happening here?
Well, my sources are no longer fully annotated and my information is somewhat anecdotal. But I believe what was once one race is now two. One above and one below. Two distinct species that have evolved.
And how do those below survive?
That is the real question, isn't it?
So he bleats like a sheep. The kid's got 3 conch shells on it. So in Spanish, for people that know Spanish, if someone calls you a concha, that means they're calling you, you know, part of the female anatomy in kind of a derogatory way. And he's wearing 3 conch shells, angel of the bottomless pit. And not only that, but his tie, if you look right here, that's not what a tie looks like at all. Then he winks and he bleats like a sheep. And when he bleats like a sheep, you know what the story is. Let's see. Here we go.
Book I recommended, The Homeward Angel by.
I'm sorry, I don't know.
And one below. Two distinct. Once one race, is now two. Somewhat anecdotal, but I believe what was once one race, is now two. One above, and one below. Two distinct species that have evolved.
And how do those below survive?
That is the real question, isn't it?
Okay, so that's probably enough of that, huh? So now things are just kind of as obvious as they can get. I don't know that I can make it any more obvious for you. Here's another one that you need to remember. What is the imamate in the Quran? It is leadership. That is the position of the prophets and the inheritance of the successors. It is the representation of Khilafa of Allah, the deputy of the messenger. Now, don't forget, I just read you where they said they split the seed and created man, which is correct. What's Elohim called in Genesis 2? So in Genesis 2, Elohim is called what? Genesis 2, Elohim that created the host body system. In Genesis 2, I'm sorry, right here. And the host of them was done. And on the seventh day, Elohim ended his work. Deputyship. That's why the flesh is under the law. Because they put you under the law when you get a flesh host body. It's the most obvious thing in the world now. And so if you don't, in the end of the world, swear allegiance to their group, well, they'll kill you, but they're going to kill everybody anyway when they, you know, proclaim that the sun's risen from the west, because they say it's too late at that time for you to even convert to Allah. They're saying, no, you should have done it already. But again, decide this day whom you will serve. If the Lord be God, then serve him. If Baal be God, then serve him. I serve El, the Almighty God. Jesus, Emmanuel, is my Lord and Savior, and I am his end time harbinger. So there it is. Okay, so here we go. Let's see what else to show you guys. Here's a really obvious, that represents the earth coming, and she's coming up out of the earth. Her leg is an insect. This is a serpent above her. You see the serpent coming out. Here's the bait for God's angels. Come and get it. Don't touch it or you'll die. Here's a little side-by-side picture with the guy's tie. There's his tie. Here's a little side-by-side image of the Virgin. There you go. And this doubles as something else as well. Okay, so let's see what else. Here we go. Let's talk about the mirror, the female twin system. Ready? Opposite directions. One facing one way. One love. See, love. And in the mirror right here, hate, love and hate. There you go. Up and down, love and hate. There you go. What about Jane's Addiction, the band Jane's Addiction? I want to show you something. Remember I showed you this. See that cross that's kind of turning right there? This says, I had a dad. And then Jane's Addiction, it's 2 twin females. Burning Jane means, I believe, God is gracious. Here is a look at the system that you're trapped in. Here is the altar in the Vatican that's in the mouth of the serpent. That whole thing is a dead sheep. And that is male reproductive system right here. There's a penis. You turn it upside down, it's the female reproductive system. And that's why this image of a dead sheep represents male, because we are destroyed by the female energy within the system. That's why the virgin becomes a dead sheep. There it is. And this is all done. All of this is done with absolute data. So the cross at Calvary, Jesus dying for your sins. You are this double cross. This represents you. This was Jonathan on here and Jonathan right here. I was double crossed. And then the one in the midst of me was Lucifer, was in the midst of me, because just like it says in Ezekiel, that thou sittest in the seat of Elohim. It means in the population of Elohim. And we are the Elohim. That's why the Bible says, have I not said you are God? Psalm 82. You are all God's Elohim, but you shall die like men. So we're Elohim, we're going to die like men, which is exactly what happened. You shall fall like one of the princes. That's how we got here. So here's Lucifer sitting in the middle of the, in between the eyes of the sheep. See? So that's what it's called, the chair of St. Peter. Okay, but he's sitting on a penis and a vagina. Think about that. So this guy, Lucifer, sitting in the midst of the seas right here, of humanity, there he is. But when you get saved, you accept Jesus as your savior, and he reconciles the male and the female energy, the good you and the bad you. He reconciles both through the cross. His purpose was to make one new man from the two, thus making peace. He's the Prince of Peace. And you can tell people that are converted because they have peace, not like these lunatic channels that are obsessed with me. If they were at peace, they wouldn't be able to do what they do. So there you go. That's why they're so panicked. Like, we gotta find something wrong. It's not gonna help. So here we go. So now, I think for you guys, y'all should all read these definitions yourself out of the Bible. I don't want to just keep going over it. But the reality that what's going on in this world now, it started in Ukraine. I don't know if y'all know this, but Ukraine, they were designating as what's called a Dia city. D-I-I-A. I did a video on it a long time ago. And Dia means gods, of city of the gods. And a lot of the stuff that's going on in Ukraine is they want to wipe it to ashes and rebuild, like, out of the ashes. Order out of chaos. Okay, so what did you learn from today? Let's see. In the Quran, it says we split the seed and created man. True. That's true. They did. Genesis 1, Elohim said, let us create man in our image. So in the image of Elohim created him, male and female. And then the angels that wanted to come in, that were willing to come in. Genesis 3 is the commingling of the two races. And you have Cain and Abel. Cannibalistic system, you're your own cannibal, and unless you get converted, you go to the pit for all eternity. All glory to God. This is overwhelming stuff, isn't it? Overwhelming. If you'll take the time to go through the folder as I have, I took the time to receive this information from the Lord. I took the time to make screenshots, put it in places where you can go through and just click one picture after the other, and it will tell you the story. If you want this stuff to sink in and you really want to know it like I do, you want to have the full confidence that when whatever goes down, that you are going to be okay, your eternal soul, then you should go through the folders, because I've handled this information so much that there's no way it's not absolutely true. It is absolutely true, and it fits with the Bible. Now it fits with the Quran as well. Wonder what the odds are. All right, guys, here's a hug from Johnny. It is super late. That's you. Love you guys. All right, guys. Peace and grace. I hope all this finds a place in your heart. We're at the door. We are at the door. We are at the door. Yes. All right, guys, I love you in Christ. Good night.